Hello and welcome to the world of recipes. I'm Vaishali and today I'm going to show you Chinese special gobi manchurian. It's a sweet, sour and tangy recipe. All the children love it. So let's see the ingredients. For making gobi manchurian, we need gobi, cauliflower 500 grams, 1 big onion chopped, 2 medium sized tomatoes chopped, half a capsicum cut into small pieces, a piece of ginger, 2 green chilies chopped, red chili powder, about 1 teaspoon, Kashmiri red chili powder, half a tablespoon, corn flour, 1 tablespoon, salt, half a tablespoon, some fresh pepper powder, maida or all purpose flour, half a cup. We need some sauces. Soya sauce as per requirement. For this recipe we'll need about 2 tablespoons red chili sauce. I will use about 1 tablespoon of red chili sauce here, and ketchup also I'll use about 3 tablespoons. Oil for frying. Now all the ingredients are ready. Let's start making manchurian. This cauliflower is washed properly and it's cut into bite-sized pieces. I have removed the stalk, only floret part is there. Now we'll make batter for gobi. Maida, corn flour. If you don't have corn flour, you can use rice atta also. Kashmiri red chili powder, red chili powder, salt. Mix all these dry ingredients together. Then we'll add in water and make thick batter. Add water slowly. Make sure there are no lumps in the batter. Now this batter is ready. This is the consistency what we want. Now I am going to crush some pepper, about 1 teaspoon. This is to give spiciness for this recipe. And I am going to add half tablespoon of soya sauce here. Mix it well. Now this batter is ready. Now this gobi florette is also dried. We'll transfer it in one big bowl and we'll pour this batter on this. And mix it well. That all the florets are covered with batter properly. Now oil is hot, let's check it. Now the oil is ready. Now drop in this cauliflower florets one by one. Whenever you are dropping this floret in the oil, make sure the floret is covered with batter properly. Whenever you are dropping this floret in the oil, make sure it is covered with this batter properly. We will fry these florets on medium heat so that the florets get cooked properly, cauliflower gets cooked properly. Don't move these florets too much, otherwise the coating will come off. Now these florets are fried properly. Drain out excess oil. Same way I will fry rest of the florets. Now all these florets are fried. Now you can see some florets are stuck to each other. Let it cool down and you can separate them before putting it into gravy. Add oil to the pan. Now the oil is hot, we'll add these onions. We don't have to make the onions brown. We will just make it translucent or little soft. Onion is soft, we'll add the green chilies. I have taken two green chilies here. If you don't want spicy gravy, you can reduce the number of chilies. And we'll freshly grate some ginger in it, about 1 teaspoon of ginger. We don't add garlic in Chinese recipes, so only ginger we'll add here. Now it's been 2 minutes, the ginger is cooking and it's done properly. Now we'll add in these tomatoes. And we'll cook it till the tomatoes become soft. Now these tomatoes are cooked, now we add this capsicum. We don't want to cook this capsicum. Saute this capsicum for 1 or 2 minutes. Now quickly we will add in some sauces. Soya sauce, about 1 tablespoon sauce, about 1/2 tablespoon, and ketchup, about 2 tablespoons. It well. We'll add in little salt, about 1 teaspoon of salt here, some chili powder, and we'll crush pepper, about 1 teaspoon of pepper we'll add here. Now you can keep this gravy as it is and add cauliflower florets to this, but if you want to make gravy, you have to just take some corn flour. I have taken about 1/2 tablespoon of corn flour. I'm going to add some water to it, about 1/4 cup of water. Mix it well. And add it to the gravy. After adding corn flour water, you have to cook it for a minute or so to remove the rawness of corn flour. Now this gravy is ready. We don't want too much watery gravy here. And now we add this cauliflower florets to this. Mix it well. You need to add these florets whenever you want to serve this manchurian. If you add it in advance, then it will become soggy and the crunchiness of florets you will not have. So whenever you want to serve this manchurian, that time only you add this florets to the gravy. Now we don't need to cook these florets in the sauce. We have to just mix it and make sure all the florets are covered with this sauce and it is ready to serve. We'll serve it hot. This yummy gobi manchurian is ready. Enjoy it. Enjoy these tangy Manchurians at your snack time.